Today I'm making a stamp of a zipper that I can use to sculpt in Mudbox, and I'm starting off in Photoshop with photo reference of an actual zipper. And from this photo reference, I'm going to create a black and white height map. So I'm going to start the process by simply painting over the zipper teeth here. And I'm using white because I suspect that this will be one of the highest points on the height map. And I'm using a fully opaque brush with sharp edges because I want this detail to be relatively solid and flat. Now, I can see that there are some parts of the zipper that are not as high as other parts. The teeth that connect into the other parts of the zippers looks like they're a little recessed. And what's more, it looks like they're rounded around the edges. So I'm going to apply a gradient on top of that as a multiply, so that I can just curve the edges of that bump map away. And then I'm going to assign an inner glow, and I'm going to set it to black and use it as a multiply. And what I'm doing here is I'm just ensuring that the edges of my objects are not too sharp. So I'll just duplicate those, and now I'm on to the next step, which is the cloth that the zippers adhere to. And trying to paint gray on top of a gray background is kind of difficult. So I'm going to use a red brush at this point and paint it in using red. And then when I've got that set, I'll desaturate the red back to gray. So Control Shift U, or I can use the menu. And then I'll update or add brightness to it. And once again, go into the layer styles and use a gradient overlay. And I'm just creating a radial gradient to give it a little bit of bulginess. And I'll use this same inner glow trick on the edges, just to make sure that at the edges, the object comes up subtly, and we don't just get a drop-off from one area to another. So I'll duplicate those, and then I'll create this other area of fabric in a very similar fashion, a simple fill. I'll overlay some gradients, and I'll put that under my other areas and add the stroke around the edges. And I'll do one last section of fabric. This is the big bulgy fabric that wraps around the edges of the zipper so that the zipper is kind of recessed and in this valley between these two big areas of fabric. And I'll use gradients to color that again. And then I'm just going to fill it all in so that I can create a repeating stamp so that I have a section that will work. So I'll use the black background because that's what Mudbox is going to expect. If I want, what I've done here is I've added a little overlay of the original textures so I get a little bit of that photo detail. And then I just need to crop the image evenly to create that tiling stamp. And it's time to bring that texture over into Mudbox. So in Mudbox, I'll click this little button here and add a stamp. And I'll just search and find wherever I put my texture. And that'll add this stamp into the lower right corner of the stamp menu. And because this is a zipper, I want to use the repeat tool. And I'll just pick the stamp image while I'm using the repeat tool. I definitely want to make sure that randomize is off. And I want to pay attention to that rotation because that's going to have an effect on this stamp, as we'll see in a moment. So my first attempt, the stamp is not strong enough at all, so I'll try it again. And when I look at it, I can see that it's turned the wrong way. So I'll rotate it, and I'll try again. And when I zoom in, it looks much more like a zipper. I can try adjusting the stamp spacing to see if that helps. I can use steady stroke on my brush. This will help give me a more even stroke on the mesh. But overall, it looks like the stamp that we've created is not working so well. So we might think that it's because it was initially rotated the wrong way. So we could try rotating it in Photoshop and then bringing it back in, just adding a stamp again and using the repeat tool to add it. But we'll see it's rotated incorrectly again, regardless of how we imported it. And the problem is actually because Mudbox is trying to paint this texture as a full square, and our texture is actually more of a rectangle. So I'm going to fill it out in Photoshop and make it an actual, much more square proportion texture, and then save that out and bring it into Mudbox and use that to create create my stamp. I see that I get something that's much closer to the zipper shape that I'm looking for. So let's look at another way that we can actually create a more smooth line, which is to use the curve tools. And the curve tools let us draw a curve onto the surface of our mesh, and then our brush will follow that curve. And in this way, we can create more complex shapes on the surface of our object. Now, we do have another option with curves as well. We can enable a tool and then go to our object list, select our curve, right-click, and do a stroke on curve, and Mudbox will automatically populate that shape with the whatever brush that we have. We'll see that stamp spacing is really important here. Stamp spacing was much too big this time, so I'll try it again with a different curve. I set my stamp spacing to a better number, a number I think that'll work better, and then I'll right-click and do a stroke on curve again. And this time we can see that the result is much more satisfactory. So let's change tracks here and talk textures. In most cases, you're going to have an extremely dense mesh to use the brush that we've created as an actual sculpt brush. In some cases, our computers won't be fast enough to handle it. So we can also use this exact same brush as a bump map. I can create a new bump map layer and use my paint tools to apply this brush in the same way. And in this way, I can get that really finely detailed resolution and apply it on top of a sculpt, even though the sculpt lacks the density that's needed to create that detail in geometry. It will still look like we've got that detail. And with that, we're done. Wasn't too hard. Hopefully you found it helpful. If you want to see more stuff like this, just check out my blog, methodj.com.